हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू नागेश करसगी और किड चैनल। आई एम वीना टीचर टीचिंग यू थर्ड स्टैंडर्ड साइंस सब्जेक्ट। व्हाट वी हैव स्टडीड इन आवर लास्ट सेशन स्टूडेंट्स? यस, टेल मी। यस, वी हैव स्टार्टेड आवर सेकेंड चैप्टर सेफ्टी एंड द फर्स्ट एड। इन द लास्ट एपिसोड वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज एन एक्सीडेंट एंड वी हैव सीन सेफ्टी रूल्स एट होम। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी द safety rules at the school. Now, whenever you are at the school, see, every day for 6 to 7 hours, you are in the school, isn't it? So, as you are following some rules at home, in the same way, you have to follow some safety rules at the school also. Shall we start? Yes, let's start. The first rule, running up and down a staircase is very dangerous. Do not push anyone on the stairs. Always form a line before you come down the staircase. Do you remember? Yes, teacher always teaches, instruct you that don't run from the staircase. Now, our orchid kids are very disciplined. Nowadays, we can see in our school that from the beginning, you people are following these rules, isn't it? You always walk on the staircase by forming the line only, isn't it? We are really proud of you. So, still, they have given this rule that you should understand. So, what they are saying? Running up and down on the staircase is very dangerous, isn't it? Your classes may be on second floor, third floor. So, you should not run up and down. And while walking on the staircase, you should not push anyone, students. Not at all. So, if you push, what will happen? He may fall. He may get hurt. He or she. Isn't it? Huh? So, always form a line before you come down the staircase. So, how you have to come down from the staircase? You have to form a line and you have to walk one by one. Isn't it? Yes, you know about this rule and you all are following this rule. Isn't it? Yes. Now, we will see the second rule. Now, what is the second rule? Classrooms are not for running and playing. The corners of the decks are sharp and can hurt you badly. Climbing on the decks and playing inside the classroom can cause accident. See, when teacher will go out of the class for hand wash in the recess, then what you will do? You start running from the benches, isn't it? You start jumping, you start running. So it is very, very dangerous. Why teacher will tell you always don't run here and there, don't run in the class, don't jump from the decks? Why she will tell you always? Because it is very dangerous for you only. See, the corners of the decks. See, do you remember your decks? See, the corners of the decks are very, very dangerous for you. Why? Because they are very sharp. If you fall on that, so you may get hurt very badly, isn't it? And climbing on the decks and playing inside the classroom can cause an accident, isn't it? Suppose you are running in the classroom and somebody pushed you by mistakenly. So may you fall on the decks or on the wall or on the floor, may you get hurt very badly, isn't it? So that's why you should not run in the classroom, you should not play in the classroom, inside the classroom. Actually, you should not run at all, because inside the classroom there are benches and benches are having corners, sharp corners. So it is very dangerous for the small students. So students, you're not going to play now inside the classroom. You're not going to climb on the decks also. Okay? So do not climb on decks. Promise? Yes. Good boys and girls. Now next. Do not run in corridors. Corridors are for walking. Now see, what is mean by corridors? Yes. Now from the classroom, every day in the short recess and for the recess, where you go? You go for hand wash and washroom, isn't it? So from where you walk from the corridors, isn't it? So how you walk? Yes, you walk or you run in the corridors? No, you walk in the corridors. So you should not run in the corridors. What will happen? Because everyone comes out of the class at the same time for the recess. If you are running, because of your running, may someone will get hurt, may someone will fall down. So it is very dangerous. So you should not run in the corridors. You should always walk in the corridors. Understood? Safety rules at school. Clear till here? Yes, students. Clear? Yes. Very good. Now, next. Now we'll move to the next. Now safety on playground. Now see, now here I would like to give you one situation. Now everyone think that some students are playing cricket match in the group. See, cricket match always students play in the group only, isn't it? And you had a fight while playing the cricket, you had a fight. And what happens? Then you started fighting with each other. Then what you people are doing? You started throwing the balls, bats, thumbs at each other. Then tell me, do you feel this can cause a serious accident, students? Yes, tell me. If you fought on the ground while playing the cricket in the group and you started throwing the ball, bats and stumps at each other, what will happen? Yes, tell me what will happen. Do you feel this can cause a serious accident? Yes, this can cause a serious, very, very serious accident. You should not fight on the ground. You should follow some safety rules on the ground. See, if you are throwing the bat, ball, stumps on each other, may someone will get hurt very, very badly. Isn't it? So, it is very, very risky. So, you should follow the safety rules that need to be followed in the playground. Okay. Now we will see. While playing on the slide or the swing, wait for your turn. Do not push anyone when you are on the slide. It can be dangerous. See, when you go to playground, everyone want to play on the slide and the swings only. Everyone like. But on the swing, anyone can sit, isn't it? So, what you people do? You will make hurry, 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 hurry. Now my turn, give me, get up. You will try to stop, but you should not do that. It is very, very dangerous. You should wait for your turn. You should not do hurry, hurry. See, while playing the slide, you should wait for your turn. You should stand in a queue in this way and you should go one by one. Otherwise, you may get hurt, isn't it? So, while playing the slide, see, if suppose these all students, one is standing here and one boy is sliding down. And suppose this here standing one boy pushed him, then what will happen? He may fall very badly. And from here, if you push backside boys, these all boys will fall down. So while playing the slide and swings, you should take care. You should not push anyone. Okay? Clear till here? Yes. The next rule. Playing game is lot of fun, but there are rules to be followed in every game. If you do not follow the rules of the game, you can hurt others. See what they are saying? Playing game. So whenever you play game, it is fun for you. You enjoy the games, you know? Yes, you enjoy the games. But there are rules to be followed in every game, isn't it? You have to follow the rules. If you do not follow the rules of the game, you can hurt others, isn't it? Now, for example, now which game you play daily? Tell me. Yes? Tell me, students, which game you like to play? Yes? Can anyone? Tell me. Now, suppose if you are playing in a group, you may play like Coco. In school at least, you play with basketball, throwing ball. You play Coco, you like to play Coco. See, in Coco also there are some rules, isn't it? You should not push. When your turn is there, you have to run after one player, isn't it? And what you will do while playing, you will push others to catch him. But if you will push him very very fast, then what will happen? The front side player will fall down. It is very, very risky. So you have to you should just touch him, and you should tell him, come on, now it's your turn, come on, you go and catch him. So whenever you are playing any game, so you have to follow some rules, otherwise you can get hurt to yourself also, or you can hurt others also. Clear till here? Yes? Understood everyone till here? Yes. Now we'll move to the next point. Before moving here, they had given one question. Now let's see. How do the rules in a game help keep players safe? Tell me. How do the rules in a game help keep players safe? Shall we see? Yes. The rules tells a player what they can and cannot do and stop them from doing things that might harm them or others. I'll repeat. The rules tells a player what they can and cannot do and stop them from doing things that might harm them or others. Clear? Yes. Now we are going to see safety on the road. Now you come to school from the road, you go back to home from the road. If you are going outside, from where you go? You go on the road only. So whenever you are walking on the road, you are going on the road, you have to be followed some safety rules. So many accidents happen on the road. Be careful when you walk to school or home. Always walk on the footpath. Yes, do you know the footpath, students? Yes. Have you seen footpath? So in this picture, you can see here, footpath is there. The man is walking on the footpath. This is road. This is what? This is zebra crossing, isn't it? See, this boy, this person is walking on the footpath, isn't it? So whenever you are walking on the road, you should be careful. You should always walk on footpath only. Keep in your mind. If you have to cross a road, use a zebra crossing. See in the signal, if you want to cross the road, what you have to use? You should use only zebra crossing, because the vehicles will not come on the zebra crossing. Vehicles always stop before the zebra crossing. So you have, if you want to cross the road from one side to other side, you have to walk on zebra crossing. Clear? Yes. When you cycle on the road, keep to your left and signal with your hand before you turn. See, if you know the cycle riding, so whenever you go on the road on cycle, so what you have to do? You should keep your cycle to your left side always. Keep in your mind. Which side? left side. Signal your hand before you turn. What you have to do? If you want to turn anywhere, you have to give signal with your hand. Yes. So, watch the traffic signals. When the light turns red, it means stop. The orange light tell you to wait. And the when the light turns green, you can go. See, red means stop. Orange means wait. Green means go. Now we will see one animation.
Safety on the road. To stay safe, you should be careful while you are on the road. You should always walk on the footpath. Vehicles should obey the traffic lights and stop when the light is red. Slow down when it turns yellow and go only when the light turns green. Always cross the road at the zebra crossing. Before you cross, look right, then left, and right again to make sure that there are no vehicles coming towards you. Never run or play on the road. It can be very dangerous. Follow these rules to stay safe.
Understood? Yes. Here one question. Why are the traffic signals important, students? Tell me. Why are the traffic signal important? See, traffic signals are important as they help traffic move in an orderly manner and prevent accident. They also help people to cross the road without getting hurt. So that's why traffic signals are very, very important. Now here two questions are there. Now give me answers. Why should you follow the safety rules? Tell me why you should follow. Yes. Why, students? Yes, we must follow the safety rules to avoid accident and keep safe. So if you want to keep yourself and if you want to avoid accident, you should follow the safety rules. Now second question. What do the colors of the traffic light means? Yes, just now we have studied and I have shown you one animation also. Tell me. Yes. When the traffic light turns red, it means, tell me, it means stop. Very good. The orange light tell us to, yes, what they tell us, orange light? To wait. And the, when the light turns green, so we can go, isn't it? Yes. Now here we are going to do one activity. Now see, choose the correct answer to complete each sentence. Click on it and press done. When you are on a busy street, you should walk on, yes, where we should walk? When you are busy, you should walk on zebra crossing, footpath or road? Footpath. Let's see.
Correct.
Very good. Next. While cycling on the road, you should keep to, yes, just now we have studied, to left side, right side or the center? Left side. Isn't it?
Correct.
Very good. Now we'll move to the next. When the traffic light is red, you should, yes, when the light is red is there, you should wait, go or stop? Red means stop. Let's see.
Correct.
Very good. Now, if a wound is bleeding, you should first, what you have to do? You should apply the cold cream or wash the wound with soap and water or wait for the doctor. So this we are going to study in the first aid. So whenever wound is bleeding, you should first wash the wound and with soap and water.
Correct.
See, you should sharpen your pencil with the, how you sharpen your pencil? With blade, knife or sharpener, what you use, students? Of course you use sharpener, isn't it?
Yippee! You have completed the activity.
Very good. So we have done with this all question. Now we'll move to the next. Last point. Now first aid. Now what is first aid? If someone get hurt in an accident, do not panic. Now see here, panic is a new word. What does it mean by panic, students? Yes, panic means to be afraid, not know what to do. Means if suddenly something will happen to anyone, then what will happen? You get panic. So you should not panic. If suddenly blood is coming from your hand, you got hurt on hand and started bleeding, so what will happen? Yes, tell me, what will happen? You start crying and again you will be too much panic, you will be afraid, isn't it? You are not getting what to do. So you should not react like that. You should be calm. Okay, so try to stay calm and help the injured person. So whenever you get hurt or somebody will get hurt, you should not panic. So you should calm and help injured person. The first help that injured person gets is called first aid. What is first aid? The first help that an injured person gets is called first aid. Now, if a wound is bleeding, wash it with the clean water. Now, what do you mean by bleeding? Yes, tell me. Yes, come on. Tell me what is mean by bleeding. Yes, to lose blood because of the wound or injury. See, if you get hurt, so what happens? Blood comes from that injury, isn't it? So that is called bleeding. Okay, so what you have to do? You have to wash with the clean water and wipe it with an antiseptic such as a Dettol. So what you have to do? You have to take one cotton and you have to use Dettol and you have to wash that place wherever you got injured. So if the bleeding does not stop, tie a bandage. Loss of too much blood is dangerous for the injured person. See, to stop bleeding, first what you have to do? You have to wash it with the clean water, then you have to wipe means you have to clean it, okay, with the antiseptic such as Dettol. You have to use Dettol and you have to wipe it, and still bleeding does not stop, then what you have to do? You have to take one bandage, you have to tie. See, if loss of too much blood is very dangerous for the injured person. So injured person should not lose too much blood. It is very dangerous for him. If someone get burnt, place the part of the body that is burnt under the running cold water. Keep it there until it stop hurting. If there are blisters, do not try to brush them. Cover the burn with the dry clean handkerchief. See, this is about we have seen bleeding. Now suppose if someone get burnt, how you get burnt? With the fire something. Okay, so what you have to do? You have to place the part of the body that is burnt under the running cold water. See, whenever you get burnt on any place, you have to keep that hand immediately under the running cold water and you have to keep it there until the stop hurting. See, once your hand or leg burn, you feel very hurting. So till where you have to keep? Until it stops hurting. If there are blisters, now what is mean by blister? Yes, bubbles on the skin with the liquid in it. See, whenever it burns, now if you are leaving hand as it is, immediately the blister will come. Blister means the bubbles on the skin. And what will be there in the bubbles? Liquid like water it comes. Okay, so if there are blusters, do not try to burst them. So you should not burst them. Okay, then what do you have to do? You have to cover the burn with a dry clean handkerchief. You should not wait your handkerchief. As they say, whenever you get burned, you have to keep your hands running cold water. So you should not keep your handkerchief cold, and you should not tie it. You should take always dry handkerchief, that too clean handkerchief, to close the bubbles. Okay, after giving the first aid to the person, ask an adult to call a doctor. See, first aid is only to say to give one satisfaction to injured person. Okay, to stop major injured. So once you give the first aid, you have to tell an adult, means your parents, mother, father, brother, sister, grandparents. You have to tell them to call a doctor. And if the person is hurt seriously, immediately call an adult and ask for a doctor. If you have seen at home somebody got hurt very seriously, then you should not give the first aid. You should call immediately an adult person and ask for a doctor, and stop people from crowding around. Only trained people should give the first aid to the seriously injured persons. Now see, everyone can't give the first aid to all the people. Okay, if they don't know what is first aid and what he what they got hurt, whether it is injured, whether it is burnt, if they know exactly which treatment, which first aid should be given to that injured person, they should be trained. If they know, then only they can go for the first aid. If they don't know, they should not try anything. Okay, now here we have completed this chapter. Here I would like to show you one presentation about first aid.
First aid is the life-saving help given to a sick or injured person before doctors arrive. Listed below are some basic things that a first aid box should have: bandage, cotton pads, antiseptic solution like Dettol, antibiotic ointment, thermometer.
See, do you have first aid box at home, students? If you have, just cross check these things are there at home in the first aid box. If you don't have first aid box at home, you are going to make your first aid box with this 5 things. Okay?
When accidents happen, you should stay calm but act fast. Look for an adult who can help. To what the person hurt is saying. Try to arrange first aid. Not move someone seriously hurt. Call a doctor. Contact the injured person's family. First aid for a cut. A small cut should be washed with water to remove any dirt. Pat it dry and a plaster applied. If the cut is deeper and continues to bleed, use a clean towel or bandage to apply pressure till it stops bleeding. Then wash and dress it. First aid for a bee sting. Do not scratch the area with your fingernails. Use tweezers to remove the sting. Once the sting is removed, wash with soap and water and apply an ice pack. If you still feel uneasy, call a doctor. Stay calm.
Clear till here? Yes, students? Now what we have studied in this chapter? So now you know that following simple safety rules will help you to avoid accident at home, at school, on the playground and on the road, isn't it? So you are going to follow all the safety rules to avoid the accident. The first help that an injured person get is called first aid. Wash a bleeding wound with water. Use an antiseptic such as Dettol. Tie a bandage around the wound if it does not stop bleeding. Hold a burned area under running cold water till the pain goes away. And after giving the first aid, ask an adult to call the doctor. Clear? Yes. Now, on page number 17, exercise is there. Okay. Now, what is your today's home assignment, students? That you have to read this full chapter once again from page number 13, 14, 15, 16. And you are going to solve this chapter exercise by your own. Okay. Clear? Question number A. MCQs. Question number B, fill in the blanks. Question number C, match the following. These three questions, read the chapter and try to solve. First, you read all the questions. I hope whatever I taught today and in the last session, you can solve these three questions immediately. But still, if you did not get any answer, once again read full chapter and solve the exercise. Okay? Now, here it's time to wind up our today's session. Now we will meet in our next session with the new chapter. Till that time, bye bye, take care and thank you.